Hey folks, Phantom Fish here. I have recently purchased an antenna upgrade for my Phantom, and what I wanted to do before I actually implement it is to do a distance test as far as radio signal goes on the antennas that I have now. And the ones that I have now are just the standard little doodads that come with it. And you can get all kinds of different upgrades. You can get ones that are actually powered by a separate battery. You can get the spiral antenna, the mushroom ones. You can get paddle antennas. And that's what I ended up getting, is a set of paddle antennas that actually are powered by the internal battery on the transmitter already. So we'll be putting those in, and we'll conduct the very same test, and we're going to see if, in fact, it does improve the range of the Phantom. It's said to, and this might just be marketing hype, but it's said to increase the distance by up to 4 times. So let's do a simple distance test now, and we'll see how far the standard antennas will let me go before I start to get any type of signal degradation. Okay, here we go. Here we go, ready to take off for our first flight test.
The home point, takeoff.
So far, so good. Coming up on 1,000 feet. Oh, there we go. Signal weak. Image transmission. Just started to get weak there for a second. Let's keep going. Starting to get choppy, isn't it? There we go, image transmission, very weak. I'm down to 2 bars. So 1900 feet. Oh yeah, I'm starting to get weak signal. Let's see if I can muscle this thing back. Oh boy, I just lost it all. Holy cow, what's going on? Trying to do the return to home because I lost connection to it. Okay, there it goes. Looks like it's coming home. Whew! That was a little scary. All right, let me see. I'll just bring this in by hand and then we'll install the new paddle antennas. Okay, the next step that we need to do is to increase the number of channels that we have. Stock channels are, there's only 8 that comes from the factory. It's like 13 through 20. And what we need to do is increase the number of channels because as per the description of the product from the manufacturer, they specify it works best on channel 22. I am not a wizard when it comes to understanding all of the channels and the radio frequencies and all that stuff. But if they say it works best on 22, then I'm going to try to do that. Enabling your channels as well helps your transmitter auto-negotiate which channel is receiving the less noise. So I think that's also where it does a little bit better as far as penetration goes. So let's take a look at what the stock channels are now. And you just click this little HD thing there at the top of your screen, and we can see that we only have 8 channels, 13 through 20. And what we want to do is we want to modify the pilot application or DJI GO, whichever app that you're using. I think DJI GO is the updated one. So we need to change that and get some more channels in there. So I think that is as easy as hooking your tablet up to your computer, just like I have right here, and then grabbing this super secret, top secret file, dropping that over here into the root directory of DJI Pilot in the files folder on your tablet. Come back here and then relaunch. Okay, so let's close this out. And let's just back all the way out, right? Keep going back all the way out. Okay, and now let's fire it up again. DJI GO. Okay, and let's get over here back into camera mode. And HD. And look at that. There's all of our channels. I just got done performing open heart surgery on my Phantom here, installing those new antennas, and we are ready to test. This is what they look like, all installed. Just a couple paddle antennas, and what's nice is that they do pop right off pretty easily. All you have to do is there's a thumb screw down there, just twist that, and they come right off. So for those of you that have cases that are a little bit worried about whether or not it'll fit, it does not fit in my case with the antennas on, but fortunately they screw right off very easily, and you can just tuck those off in, to the side. So overall, I'd say the installation went pretty well. There was a couple tedious areas trying to get those cables out, but all in all, pretty well. It probably took me about 35 to 40 minutes to do it all. Let's give this thing a test flight. Now, if you remember, the number to beat was 1,900 feet. Now, bear in mind, I have a lot of trees and houses that I'm going through, so I'm mainly concerned about radio signal penetration. If I was out in the open desert with no obstacles, no doubt I would probably get much, much further than 1,900 feet. But for now, that's the number to beat, and we're just going to see if we can get maybe to 2,000. Let's give it a try. Here we go. Okay, here we go. Test flight. Number 2. Number to beat is 1,900 feet. Let's see how well we do. Okay, taking off.
The home point has been a takeoff.
Okay, now that I'm up here, I just want to verify that my channels are looking good. I mean, I don't see any activity or anything, but maybe it's just because I'm still so close. All right, let's take it out here. Coming up on 300, 400, 500, 800. About 1,000. So far, so good. This is the creek where it started to get choppy. That dark creek up there. 1,500. Doing good. There was a little bit of a glitch there. Oh, same thing. Same thing. There's 1,800 feet. I'm just bringing it up a little bit more, so I'm not going through so many trees. 1,900 is beat. I'm starting to lose a little bit of signal. So what happens if I open up my signal thing here? See, it doesn't have any activity or anything like that. If I switch it to auto, let's see how that changes. Wow. I switched it to auto and immediately dropped a signal weak, and then it found a different one. But it's still, I think it's still weak. I'm pushing out over 2,000 feet though. I can definitely go further. Look at this. And I think what it's happening there, when it flashes like that, when it goes signal weak and then it goes right back to safe to fly, I think it's changing channels. But I mean, I am definitely far, much further than where I was before. Let's spin it around and bring it back. Well, I gotta say, I'm pretty pleased with the increase. It's not a huge increase, but then again, I am going through a lot of obstacles here, a lot of trees. My house is just nestled down in there in those trees, and I think that's going to be, you know, a lot of my signal problems right there is the penetration. If this was all wide open land, I think we would be in real good shape and be able to really go fast now, or far rather. Regarding the channel 22 versus auto, I don't know. I guess maybe I just don't understand it as much. It seemed to work better for me when it was set on auto. But, well, there you have it, folks. Let me just give you a quick rundown here. Okay, so let's break it down. First on the list is cost. These things run about $59, and I got it for no tax and free shipping off of blueproton.com. Pretty good deal. Not nearly as expensive as some of the other aftermarket antenna upgrades that you can get. You can get some really, really expensive ones, and you can get some cheap alternatives as well. Some of the antenna reflectors, you can get those as cheap as like 10 bucks. But this is kind of middle of the road, and $59 is probably what you can expect. Next on the list is the look. And you know what? I actually... I'm pretty fond of the look. I like how it has kind of stuck with the white theme, and it kind of makes the entire transmitter all look very sleek, and everything matches. Yeah, if you're one of those goofballs like me, that matters. But overall, I'm pretty impressed with the look. Pretty sleek. Let's see, what else is there? Installation, you know, as you saw, can be pretty involved, but overall, not terrible. Pretty easy. I was able to get that in and installed probably about 45 minutes. If you are a little intimidated about digging through the internals of your transmitter, then it may not be the solution for you. You might want to get some of the, maybe the reflectors that just kind of snap on your stock antennas and that, you know, work with that. It will increase your range a little bit, maybe not as much, but it is a cheaper alternative. Size, they are a bit bigger. These antennas are definitely a bit bigger. They're not as tall, but you can't fold them down and collapse them the same as you can with the stock antennas. So it may make putting it away into your case a little bit more difficult. But overall, I do like how they easily unscrew and detach off the transmitter, so you can still store them somewhat easily. If you had one of the very large externally powered antennas, good luck trying to fit those in your case. So this is a nicer alternative when it comes to packing and storing your transmitter away. Let's see, what else is there? The channel upgrade requirements. It's not really a hack, and it's not a alteration of the application that you have in regards to modifying the version or anything like that. You're adding a file to the existing application. You're not replacing a file, okay? So if that makes you feel a little bit better. So it's not truly a hack, but you are unlocking something that is not natively there. So read into that however you may. But I would say, you know, for all intents and purposes, it is a safe modification to the application. But that is also required to take full advantage of these antennas. As the marketing says, channel 22 works the best. Well, yeah, whatever, right? If that's true or not, I didn't necessarily see that, but maybe I only tested it once, and maybe if I test it again in some different terrain with less obstacles, then, you know, maybe it'll work better. And speaking of that, range increase, I did see some. I saw a little bit of range increase. The penetration, you know, I do have a lot of obstacles where I was testing the flight. A lot of different, you know, houses in the suburb that maybe have a ton of wireless routers, and there's a lot of other stuff in there that can hinder my signal performance. And it seemed to do okay with that. The penetration and the range increase was there. It wasn't significant. I mean, the marketing claims 4 times as much as the, you know, standard range. And did we see that? No, we didn't see that. Again, if I was out in the middle of the desert, you know, with no other Wi-Fi signals around, no interference and no obstacles and no need for penetration, well then, yeah, maybe we would see it. Okay, but we didn't see it in this case, but we did see an improvement. So, is it worth it? Well, that's for you to decide. Okay, this is Phantom Fish here. Hope you enjoyed the video. Click that like button and subscribe, and we'll see you back here soon. Fly safe. Take care.